Colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, I am Radoslav Dosen. I am from the Research Institution for Veterinary in Novi Sad for the protection of domestic and wild pigs. I am presenting this topic on behalf of my colleagues.
Causes
of disease in domestic as well as in wild pigs are man as well as other factors.
There is
a lack of information concerning the way of transmission, so we have speculation. There is little known about the pathology and the epidemiology and epizootiology when we are speaking about wild pigs and about the measures which need to be taken.
Many countries that applied for the eradication measures against zoonoses, such as TBZ, brucellosis, trichinellosis, did not manage in eradication because there were reinfections as the outcome which were caused by wild boar. Therefore, we wanted to go to see the critical points in epizootiology of wild pigs. The factors that are important regarding this problem, first of all, the structure of pig production here in Serbia. Pigs are produced on a great number of domestic farms. Nearly to 400,000. That is an important factor when we talk about the eradication. Then we have the increase of mini farms and the big farms, and also we have the pastures where pigs go to feed. The population of wild boars could be very fast in production, and there is also the importance of hunting as a tourist branch. Viruses in wild boars could be caused for zoonoses, such as the virus of hepatitis, then Oyeski disease, psychoviruses, encephalitis, Japanese classical swine fever, then parvoviruses, pyrovirus, African fever, swine influenza, porcine viruses, and so on. And there are numerous bacteria found in different countries, including Serbia. The most important source is pathological agents present in wild pigs, parasites. Therefore, we should take care of especially dangerous diseases, infectious diseases, such as endemic swine diseases. This is a scheme that shows the way of transferring the disease. Every arrow should be stopped. Through the legal or illegal import of swine, it could be a way of entering the disease of other sorts of disease. So the agent could go through vectors, and then the infection could occur. And then the reproduction techniques and inadequate feeding could be the way of entering of the infectious agent into the farm. The disease is passed in two ways, through direct and indirect contact. Sexual contact is direct contact for the disease transmission, and the other one is indirect through the objects such as shoes and so on. Fecal-oral disease, ways of transmission through ticks, insects, and so on. While the pigs that live in a free area are very important for biosafety measures which are to be undertaken, interaction with the wild boars, with domestic pigs in extensive grazing is also very dangerous. This is a case in an orchard. There is a small fence which doesn't mean anything when we talk about wild boars. They make immediate contact here. This is the interaction with wild boars. Organic swine production, the sort called mangulica, is very popular because they say meat is very healthy. However, there also could be direct contact between wild boars and domestic swine. All the photos taken are original, taken on our field and terrain with the immediate contact. The pictures are really nice, and the swine enjoy themselves in the surrounding, but this is very dangerous. Way of contact. And also there is in extensive grazing in the woods. This is also very dangerous because of the direct contact. They are mostly in buildings of this kind. Apart from humans, there is a dog, which could also be one of the vectors for the transmission of infectious diseases. Since they live freely in the woods, direct contact is possible. And we have found this with one peasant. This is a hybrid between a wild boar and a domestic pig. They are light introduction to the villages, another additional problem. Feeding place should be under control, especially because of the danger of the moldy of the molds and the mycotoxicoses which occur in the field.
Sada imamo komponentu čovjek.
Now we have a component called a human. There is a human being in the woods. That human being prepares himself food and he throws away all the reminders of his food. When men interact, then the whole thing becomes dramatic. It was one carcass floating around the neighboring river. Carcasses are discarded and enable possibility for the contact with the live animals. So these are dead live wild boars. Their carcasses were not removed. There are different situations, many of them seen on these photos, with the possibilities of direct contact between men and wild boars. As soon as a wild boar listened to the sound of a tractor, the animal joined us and followed us. This is the immediate contact of a man and a wild boar. In such a way, the wild animal becomes tame. We also found that they have duroc animal in order to improve the quality of meat. Now, this is... Let's go back to hunting. Wild boars were killed here, and the evisceration was performed after hunting at the spot. Why? Because to feed other wild boars, to feed other wild animals. If the evisceration is dangerous because the consumption can lead to infection with the cysts of infectious agents. This is a critical control point. It should be changed. Evisceration after hunting could be at the spot or the are only in the evening when they take pictures, and only after that they take out the intestine and internal organs. It is very well known that 2 hours after harvesting, microorganisms go directly into the meat from intestines. E-manipulation of carcasses is also dangerous for the transmission of infectious diseases. Transportation. Before and after the transport, the vehicles should be cleaned and disinfected. And this is where dead wild boars were brought into the village with the evisceration at the spot with all other species of wild boars. Our hunters do not pay attention to the hygiene of hands. They should work with gloves and in special clothing to protect themselves. Nothing is so black. There are many facilities in which this whole is done within precise facilities with good healthy measures. A lot of education of farmers and the hunters and the gamekeepers should be performed in order to intensify investigation within this field, because there is a lacking number of investigation. The protocols which should lead hunters and farmers and game wardens and wild animals should be kept together. Thank you.